Hi, my name is Muhammad Al-Faki from Sudan, Africa, and I am independent scientific researcher in physical and mechanical engineering field. Today I will show you my second invention related to plasma science, or it may be called gas ionization. Or maybe it is combination between gas ionization and heat process of material by using low voltage. Making visible light without using any glass or plastic shield by using low voltage directly, it seems impossible, but I have succeeded, and I wasn't intending to design a system for lightning purposes. All these events happened coincidentally, or you can say by luck, after I observed a strange natural phenomenon while I was in the middle of one of my experiments in home to ignite the LPG gas cooker by using low voltage of DC electrical source rather than using matches. Few weeks ago, I was made three experiments for ignition the LPG gas cooker, but I failed, and I think that strange phenomenon has been appeared in the second experiment and disappeared after a while. In that time, I did not care too much about it. After I failed to ignite LPG gas because the temperature wasn't too high, I returned back to that strange phenomenon and asked myself why it happened after a long time of experiment too. I was thinking that LPG gas has been ionized by low voltage, but it seems that not happened actually because the light was being observed in air too. So I decided to focus on the strange phenomenon, as maybe it is the key for making new technology for lightning and other interesting applications. A new chemical compound was created in the experiments, and it was responsible for the bright emissions or visible light. This new material has ability not only to prevent oxidation process, but also it acts as a conductor or insulator. That means there is a threshold or ceiling voltage let us to transit from insulation to conduction properties similar to diode, transistor, or LED devices. In the beginning, we will give a quick scientific information about gas ionization and its application. Secondly, we will recite a short history of light development among past centuries. Then we may show the experiments of strange phenomenon, and finally we will mention some physical features and my hypothesis of what happened in that strange phenomenon. Until today, we have known five states or phases of matter, and each state has its unique physical characteristics. They are solid, liquid, gas, plasma, Bose-Einstein condensates. The last state, it occurs when atoms cool it down to a fraction of degree above absolute zero, coalesces together to form a superatom that behave as one entity. Plasma is gaseous mixture of free electrons and ions that have a high mean kinetic energy. Naturally, air is considered as good insulator of electricity because they don't have free electron in opposite to the metallic material, such as iron and copper. We know that oxygen and nitrogen atom has a free electron on its outer orbital, so why it is being insulator? That's because the same atom will interact chemically or electromagnetically to make a covalent double bond, like which definitely don't have any free electron in that special condition, unless you break down this double bond by some kind of energy. Sometimes it's known as dielectric voltage of gas. That's the reason why air cannot pass electricity, and there is no free single atom of oxygen, hydrogen, or nitrogen in normal circumstances. In the situation of breakdown, air or gas will be called gas, ionized gas, or plasma, and pass electricity as good conductor. Elements of column 8A in periodic table, such as helium and neon, are naturally charged particles as the outer shell of atom is full of electron. So it has not an equivalent bond with neighbors atoms. So why there are lamps used neon as lighting, for example? We can extract an electron from any atom if we apply the suitable amount of energy voltage for dislodge that electron from fully outer shell of atoms. That's exactly happened with noble gases, but as we know, a higher voltage means waste of power, and it's more convenient to use that power to ionize gas with low voltage. Electricity is similar to climb high mountain with carrying stones. If the amount of stones are too much, you will suffer from stress of muscle and you cannot reach the top of mountain. But the situation will be easy if you take the same amount of stones for lower level of mountain. The stones are represent the value of fuel consumption of machine. Increasing the fuel consumption will increase the performance and production of work, and consequently the economical benefits in short time of job. A plasma may be produced in the laboratory by heating a gas to an extremely high temperature, which causes such vigorous collision between atoms and molecules that electrons are ripped off from yielding the requisite electron and ions. There are many methods for ionizing the gas, which are particle impact ionization, thermal ionization, nuclear emission, photo or radiative ionization, 5, electric field ionization. Electric field has been subcategorized into arc discharge ionization, corona discharge ionization. In electric field ionization, there is a threshold voltage which must be achieved to start the sparking potential. Every gas has its unique minimum value for initiate the ionization process, as we see in this table. Bastian's laws, which referred to German physicist Friedrich Bastian, describes the effect of temperature, pressure, and gap length of discharge ionization. The pressure and gas gap is a critical factor to determine the required value of electrical voltage. Breakdown potential of air is expressed as a power function in PD, as we see in this photo. In standard temperature and pressure, STP, the required voltage for air ionization is 30,000 volts for gap length of 1 centimeter, or 3 kilovolt per millimeter. Now, let's talk about where we can see gas ionization in our life. Sun, interplanetary, and interstellar space are a real scientific proof for the existence of plasma in our universe. It is not liquid or gas as we think. So it must be a new state of matter in universe. Ionization of gas takes place also in Earth. One of the most familiar phenomena caused by ionization of gas is the aurora borealis, or northern lights. The Earth itself is immersed in thin plasma called the solar wind and surrounded by a dense plasma called ionosphere. There are many applications uses the principle of gas ionization, such as neon and fluorescent lamps. electrical discharge, welding arc, automobile engine combustion and diesel exhaust treatment, corona effect, radiation detector Geiger Müller counter or the ionization chamber, mass spectrometry, radiation therapy, heating equipment like coffee, toaster and iron.